Deputy Speaker, my question is for the Premier. My office has been flooded with emails and calls from constituents who are angry that they're being denied access to essential vision care. Yesterday, I heard from Jennifer, who's an Indigenous parent in my riding. Jennifer's 14-year-old daughter, Autumn, has had headaches and burning eyes for almost 2 months now. Jennifer is concerned that her daughter has developed an eye issue, but when she called her local optometrist to make an appointment, she was shocked to learn that no one under the age of 20 or over the age of 65 is able to visit an optometrist here in Ontario right now. She was told that if Autumn needed eye care, that the only option would be to take her to the emergency room. Jennifer wants to know why her daughter has to suffer because this government is refusing to negotiate a fair deal with optometrists.
Reply. Member for Eglinton Lawrence.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and thank you to the member opposite for the question. I feel very much for Jennifer and her daughter, Otta, I can tell you that we're certainly extremely disappointed that, at the urging of the Ontario Optometrists Association, optometrists have chosen to withhold publicly funded services from children and seniors. It's due to the fact that the OAO has selected a mediator, refused to meet the mediator's conditions, and has refused to come back to the table for negotiations, although there is a standing invitation to do so. It's especially concerning because optometrists keep telling members of the public that they are ready to negotiate, but they do not come back to the table. The current impasse lies squarely at the feet of the Ontario Optometrists Association, and we are more than anxious to get them to come back to the table to negotiate a fair deal. We've put an offer on the table. We've made an upfront good faith payment of $39 million, and we're really hoping that they will come back so we can make sure that residents get the care that they deserve.
Supplementary question.
Thank you, Speaker. Calls to my office from people unable to make an appointment with their optometrist are becoming more desperate. It has now been almost 2 months since seniors and kids in our province have been unable to access necessary vision care. The previous Liberal government badly underfunded vision care for kids and seniors, letting this problem spiral out of control, but now this government is refusing to pay for a fair plan with optometrists. They simply don't want to spend the money to ensure that children and seniors in this province have access to essential vision care. When will this government get back to the table and negotiate in good faith with the optometrists?
Member for Eglinton Lawrence.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and thank you again to the member opposite. We are at the table, ready, willing, and able to negotiate every day. There is a standing invitation, as I said, from the mediator who was chosen by the Ontario Optometrists Association, and we are all ready to negotiate any time they will come back to the table. So we encourage everybody out there to encourage optometrists to come back to the table. That is the place that a deal will happen. But I can tell you that this government is acting in good faith. We've already put a fair and reasonable offer on the table, including an immediate compensation increase of 8.48% retroactive to April 1st to catch up increases that physicians had over the last 10 years or so since optometrists last had an agreement. Also, a one-time payment of $39 million, which has already gone into the accounts of optometrists, again, to catch up. Future fee increases to align with physician increases, and also an immediate working group to go over their other concerns and continue to negotiate. We are ready, willing, and able. We hope they will come back to the table immediately so that people like Jennifer and Otta can get the care that they deserve.